During the later portion of the 19th century and into the first half of the 20th century, the American city underwent a dramatic change. People began to migrate to the cities in hopes of finding work and starting a new urban life.
Many of the northern American cities began to see a population increase with the flooding of unskilled labor from rural areas, with a large portion being African Americans from southern states. Many of these cities began to see an economic downturn, with the urban core of cities losing its capital to suburban growth. Housing in turn became a larger and larger issue in terms of public and private financing, concentration of poverty, and the overall tarnished image of the American city due to the blighted slums.
Many city planners and city officials believe concentrated public housing to be the solution. There have been minor attempts to address this problem through public housing, but the concept of multiple public high-rise complexes has not been executed at this point in history.
The federal government decided to address these problems associated with America's overcrowded cities in 1949. They did this through the Housing Act of 1949, which is part of Harry Truman's Fair Deal. In essence, the act provided incentives for developers to expand to the suburbs. In addition, it encouraged potential buyers to move from their homes in the cities to the suburbs.
With a large portion of capital and tax base relocating to the suburbs, the American city experienced decay and deterioration. This created the city's slums to grow and take up a larger portion of the city. The Federal Housing Act of 1949 addressed the slums by imposing the provision of Title I, which federally financed slum clearance programs associated with urban renewal projects.
By 1923, an urban planner by the name of Harlan Bartholomew mapped out and